war was over, I was living with my folks. I yelled upstairs, "Hey Ma, I'm off to grab some smokes." And my father called, "Why you need to smoke so late?" I'd lied, I had a date. Free of my folks' enslavement, skipping along the pavement to see a brunette who I never met, but I never would forget how she looked in that dress. How she stuck out her hand and said, "My name is Cecily Smith, and I hope you like music, 'cause I've got to tickets for La Traviata." That's when I said, "I hate opera." She laughed and said, "Well, lucky for you that you're with Cecily Smith. Who cares what you are listening to? It's who you're listening with." We take our seats, her hands are folded in her lap. Not a kiss, then I at least will get a nap. So I close my eyes as the orchestra begins. Then I hear violins, and the hair on my neck was rising, a feeling new and surprising. But it wasn't the sound that made my heart pound. No, it was because I found that her hand is in mine, and that's where it will stay until they play the final chord. She says, "Were you bored?" And I say, "I guess it wasn't quite so bad. It was the best time that I ever had." She laughed and said, "Well, lucky for you, I got seats to Beethoven's Fifth. Cares what you are listening to, it's who you're listening with." A perfect wife, a perfect from a gun. A week, a year, and then the marriage and a son, and a rental where I still can hear her laugh when I play the phonograph. And I let the music guide me, and Cecily sits beside me. A girl of 19 with a nervous marine, feel her head begin to lean as the melody soars. It's sad but true how much I miss you. I miss you, Cecily Smith. Life is not the things that we do, it's who